Good morning. Good morning. Welcome back to Coffee and the Word. I'm slept in a little bit this morning. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Real quick, as a reminder, if you're a member of Joy Lutheran Church, we are not having in-person worship this morning. Pastor Randy will have a service on Facebook Live, so I hopefully you'll be able to join us there. But this morning, let's get going. Oh, that's good coffee. Been sitting here talking with my son this morning. My coffee got cold, but that's all right. All right. Well, this morning on Coffee and the Word, the Revised Common Lectionary takes us. We're going to start off with a reading in Isaiah, and then we're going to Psalm 36, and then 1 Corinthians, and then the Gospel of John. So, let's get going. Isaiah chapter 62, verses 1 through 5. And as always, may God bless the reading of His Word. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent. And for Jerusalem's sake, I will not rest until her vindication shines out like the dawn and her salvation like a burning torch. The nations shall see your vindication and all the kings your glory. And you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. You shall no more be termed forsaken, and your land shall no more be termed desolate. But you shall be called, My delight is in her, and your land married. For the Lord delights in you, and your land shall be married. For as a young man marries a young woman, so shall your builder marry you. And as the bridegroom rejoices over the bride, so shall your God rejoice over you. All right. Next, we're going to Psalm 36, verses 5 through 10. So here we go. Your steadfast love, O Lord, extends to the heavens, your faithfulness to the clouds. Your righteousness is like the mighty mountains. Your judgments are like the great deep. You save humans and animals alike, O Lord. How precious is your steadfast love, O God. All people may take refuge in the shadow of your wings. They feast on the abundance of your house, and you give them drink from the river of your delights. For with you is the fountain of life. In your light we see light. O continue your steadfast love to those who know you, and your salvation to the upright of heart. Amen. A little coffee here. You know, incidentally, I was at Kroger last night, and I went over to the discount rack where they have things marked down. And for 99 cents, I bought a bag of Starbucks coffee, but it was eggnog spice coffee. I figure for a dollar, I'll try it. That's not what this is. All right, on to the New Testament, the epistle lesson this morning, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 1 through 11. And here we go. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brothers and sisters, I do not want you to be uninformed. You know that when you were pagans, you were enticed and led astray to idols that could not speak. Therefore, I want you to understand that no one speaking by the Spirit of God ever says, Let Jesus be cursed, and no one can say, Jesus is Lord, except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, the discernment of spirits. To another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually just as the Spirit chooses. All right. All right. Well, next we're going on this Sunday after Epiphany. The gospel reading this morning, the Gospel of John, chapter 2, verses 1 through 11. And here we go. I absolutely love this story. So here we go. On the third day, there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine gave out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what concern is that to you and to me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now standing there were six stone water jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. And Jesus said to them, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the chief steward." So they took it. When the steward tasted the water that had become wine and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and then the inferior wine after the guests have become drunk, but you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this, the first of his signs, in Cana of Galilee, and revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. And this is the word of the Lord. I always love that story. That wine must have tasted amazing. And it always brings up the saying in my mind, the foretaste of the feast to come. And that wine must have been amazing. But anyway. All right, this is the word of the Lord. And as always on Sundays, the Revised Common Lectionary has a series of prayers. And I would like to read some of those. So, let us pray. O God, you spoke your word and revealed your good news in Jesus the Christ. Fill all creation with that word again, so that by proclaiming your joyful promises to all nations and singing of your glorious hope to all peoples, we may become one living body, your incarnate presence on the earth. Amen. And then, to God who welcomes all in love, let us pray for the good of the church and the concerns of those in need. And I would like to lift up some prayers for everyone affected by this, by COVID, and offer prayers. I have family members over in the East Coast, or towards the in the mountains on the east. They're covered in snow this morning, and I just pray that everyone is safe and they have power and the water and everything. So. Anyway, and God of every land and nation, you have created all people, and you dwell among us in Jesus Christ. Listen to the cries of those who pray to you, and grant that as we proclaim the greatness of your name, all people will know the power of love at work in the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And O God of steadfast love, at the wedding in Cana, your son Jesus turned water into wine, delighting all who were there. Transform our hearts by your Spirit, that we may use our varied gifts to show forth the light of your love as one body in Christ. Amen. All right. Well, I hope and pray that you all have a fantastic day. The wind's not looking so bad here yesterday. We had 30-plus mile-an-hour wind gusts yesterday, and it was just... it was very windy, so hopefully it calms down today and I go for a bike ride. So anyway, y'all have an awesome day and be blessed and all that good stuff. So be happy, be safe, and be blessed. And we'll see you tomorrow morning on Coffee and the Word. God bless. Bye-bye.